In the raw material master, user need to define the code for each precious raw material which is being used in the factory and for which stock is being maintained. First is RM category. Your system allows the user to deal in the following raw material. First is alloy, then C for color stone, D for diamonds, G for gold, L palladium, M other metals, P platinum, S silver, and X is accessories. We'll first take the example of diamonds. Then is the subcategory. Then there is next field is RM subcategory. The raw material category is further categorized in the raw material subcategory, which is basically the shape or the subtype of that RM. The RM subcategory need not be necessarily shape, but from implementation point of view, it is preferred that RM subcategory is defined shape wise. The shape here is round. Raw material code. The raw material code over here is RDWHSI1. RM code is usually consist of shape of the diamond, RD that is round, the color of the diamond that is WH white, and SI1 that is the quality of the diamond. Next is unit of measurement. Unit of measurement is the unit of measurement for each raw material. This will be the unit of measurement in which user would want to maintain the stock of these RM. It can be carats or grams. In case of diamonds, it is usually carats, and in case of metal, it will be grams. Then the color of the RM. Next is QW sale. That is, while calculating the sale value for this particular quality, system should multiply the rate by W or by Q. W is by diamond weight and Q is the number of stones, that is number of pieces of this particular diamond. Same way is the cost value. While calculating the cost value, system should multiply by the cost rate by weight of the diamond or the quantity of the diamond. Next is size to weight group. To understand this option, first we will need to understand the concept of size to weight chart. System has the provision to define the weight chart for each raw material subcategory based on the size. The size to weight chart stores the per piece weight of the given RM subcategory against a given raw material size. For example, the size to weight chart is defined over here, where user is saying that round diamond ranging between size 1 to 2.5 will weigh 0.08 carat, that is 8 cents. Here we can see that the size to weight chart is defined at the RM shape level, that is RM subcategory level. This chart is defined at the RM subcategory level and not for the RM code level. But at the same time, it is not necessary that all the qualities of round ranging between this size will vary the same weight given over here. So to resolve the issue, system has introduces the concept of size to weight group, where user can say that the round qualities belonging to size to weight group A1 ranging between size 1 to 2.5 will weigh 0.07 carats, where else all the other RM codes belonging to default size to weight group will weigh 0.08 carats. And later in the raw material master, user can map the particular RM code to a given size to weight group, which can be the default size to weight group or
can be A1 or B1, whatever is defined in the system. Next is customer. Here,
user can specify the customer code if the particular diamond is being supplied by the customer. This will help the user to calculate the handling charges later at the order level. Next is customs code. The code or the name by which it should be referred at the time of the exports. It accepts a valid code as defined in the customer RM master. Next is RM parent code. The parent code concept is basically for diamonds and the color stone. Parent code is required to derive the stocks for a group of diamond qualities. Now we'll first understand the concept of parent code. To understand this concept, we'll take an example of Princess Diamond. Here, since the user wants the separate stock for grooved and ungrooved Princess Diamond, for quality A1, he has to open a two different quality code, say PRG A1, PRUG A1. But at the same time, when he wants to procure the stock for Princess A1 quality, he needs to define the parent code as A1. So as to group this two RM code under one category, that is A1. This will help the user to procure the stock reports separately for grooved and ungrooved diamond, as well as the compiled stock report for quality A1. Next are the description fields. First is the description of the RM code, the detailed description of the RM code. Next is the international quality. The RM code internationally known as. Then is the print description which needs to be printed on the reports. Then is the valid yes no option. Here user can mark a particular RM code as valid or invalid. To come out of this frame, user needs to click on the OK button. The options asked over here are the filter options, basically, where while fetching the records, user can filter the data. Next, we will look into the colorstone masters. The options and fields asked over here is same as the diamond raw material. So we will move to the next RM category, that is gold. In the case of gold, there is no shape, so we define subcategory as dash. Then the caratage of the diamond, whether it is a 14 carat gold or a 18 carat. Next is the unit of measurement. As said previously, the unit of measurement for metal is usually in grams. Then the carat of the gold, color of the gold, the QW sale and the QW cost is basically while calculating the sale value or cost value, where the system should multiply the rate by quantity or by weight. Then the specific gravity of the metal, then the rate purity. The purity of the gold that would be used for calculating the sales rate of the piece. The production purity. The production purity can be same as the rate purity, or else it can be different if the company follows a different purity on the production floor. In that case, for calculating loss or to get the stocks in terms of pure, system will consider the purity factor defined over here to get the actual stock and the actual loss calculation. Next is Z purity. The purity factor to be considered for customs related document is defined in this field. Per piece weight,
it has been provided over here, but is actually useful in the case of accessories. So we'll get the better understanding of per piece weight when we are understanding accessories raw material master. We can define the customer if the gold has been supplied by the party. Next is the customs code. Custom code is being, as this raw material code is being referred in the customs document. Alloy code. If the given RM code is being made using a specific alloy code, then we can mention the alloy code over here. Here we complete the understanding of gold.
The entry screen for gold, platinum, palladium, silver and other metal is same. So we will move to the next RM category, that is X. Here, the subcategories can be defined as chain, post, pushbacks, head, etc., which are the subtypes of the accessories. Then comes the raw material code. Here, the raw material code is defined as chain 18 carat wide full. Then the unit of measurement, that is grams. Then the caratage of the accessories and the color of the accessories. Next is the QW sale and cost option, where user can specify the value as Q or W. If the accessories needs to be multiplied by the quantity of the accessories to get the sale value, user need to specify the value as Q, or else he will define it as weight, that is W. Same way is the QW cost option. Next is the finding weight per piece. Here user needs to define the per piece weight of the given finding. This will help the user to get the per piece weight while defining the raw material, bill of raw material in the design master. Then the customer code. If the particular finding is been supplied by a party, then user can specify the customer code over here. Next is the customs code for it. This is the code by which a given finding will be referred in the export documentation. Then the base code of the finding. Usually a finding is made up of gold, so user can specify the gold caratage by which this finding is made up of. Then the base production purity. This will help the user to know the pure gold stock in terms of finding lying in the factory. Then is the base code. The findings are usually made up of the metals like gold and silver, palladium, etc. So user needs to define the respective base code and the production purity for the same. This will help the user to know the stock of silver, gold in pure lying in the factory in the terms of accessories. Next is alloy. Alloys are basically used while making 14 carat or 18 carat or gold of different caratage. Now for example, when the piece of 14 carat is melted, user needs to know the weight of the pure gold and also the weight of alloy which would be recovered from the same. Here the subcategory is defined as dash and then the raw material code for the given alloy. Next is the unit of measurement, that would be grams always. Then the color of the alloy, specific gravity of the same. After the RM code is defined for alloy, we can also define in the system the raw material composition required for the 1 gram of a particular alloy, that is the proposition of each RM required to make 1 gram of that alloy. For example, here the brass of 60 milligram is required to make this particular alloy. For example, over here, to make 1 gram of this alloy coat, system will require brass of 60 milligrams and silver of 40 milligrams. This will help the user in future in the case of melting, where user can come to know how much of brass or silver or any other precious RM can be recovered from melting the design pieces. Here we complete the understanding of raw metal master, and now we'll move to the next master, that is custom RM master. Here we define the codes for the RM as to how it will be referred during the exports. Here, different qualities can be clubbed under one custom code. For example, for gold, even though we make pieces in different caratages like 14 carat, 18 caratage, but whenever the purchases are received or exports are done for these 14 carat or 18 carat pieces, we record them in terms of pure, that is G24. So here we will make the code as ZG24. Same way for the diamonds also. Whenever the diamonds are being purchased or exported, they are recorded in terms of their shapes. For diamonds, we can define the different shapes as a custom codes. Now it is advisable to define a fewer custom codes so that the maintenance of custom stock becomes easier. The next very important master in the system is design master. In design master, we store the details of existing designs for which orders are being received on daily basis. This is the design code field. It is a 15 character field where user can define a code for the given design. Next is size. Each design should compulsorily have one record with the design code and size as blank. If the details of a design differ based on its size, then different records have to be made with the design code and the respective size. Next is design category, where we can define whether a design is bracelet, pendant or ring. Next is unit of measurement. It can be pieces, pairs or set. Pieces can be defined for rings, pendants, pairs for earrings and set for the designs available in the set. Next is description. Here user can define one line description for the given design. Next is design log. A design can be logged to avoid editing of it by mistake by the user. The default which system brings for a new design is no. Then password. To unlock the design, user has to give the correct SEO password, that is special executive password. Then only system will allow the user to make the design lock as no and to edit the master. Then valid yes no, user can mark the design as valid yes or no. Next is a valid company code. Here user can specify the company code to which a design belongs to, and if the user has a rights to that particular company, then only he'll be allowed to edit the details of this particular design. Next is the general details of the designs. First is production category. Here, a design can be set as a ring easy or ring complex based on the complexity involved in the manufacturing of the given design. And based on this, the worker will be given production points. That is, higher points will be assigned for a complex design as compared to the easy designs. Next is the sales category. In the sales category field, the design is categorized from the sales point of view. When a salesperson will analyze the sales report, he or she can analyze the sales based on the sales category. And based on this data, a salesperson will decide on which sales category he or she needs to concentrate more so as to improve the sales of that particular design. Next is validation category. It is a category, it should be referred under for validation during the export. Example, studded jewelry or a plain jewelry. It tells us the loss allowed by the custom for this type of design at the time of the exports. For example, in case of studded jewelry, customs admit a loss of 9%, whereas for the plain jewelry, it allows for 3.5% loss. Next is the loss category. The loss category to which this design belongs to is specified over here. Now, user has a provision where he can charge for loss percentage to the customer. This is defined at the design category level. But it is not necessary that all the ring will incur the same loss. So, to differentiate between the design category based on the loss percentage, system asks for loss category. For example, there can be a loss category called multi-piece casting or a single piece casting. Then user can charge for loss percentage on all the ring with the multi-piece casting at the rate of 10 and all the ring with the single piece casting at the rate of 7. Next is caratage. It is the caratage in which the first sample piece is being manufactured. Next is back pieces. Back pieces is the default number of pieces that a bag should contain when the bag for this designs are generated. It gets copied to the sales order entry where it can be altered later. Set code. If two or more designs can form a set, they will be given a same set code. This code will be displayed in the design code help so that the design with the similar set code can be easily identified. Then the old code. Prior this code, if the design was being referred by some other name, then it can be mentioned over here for a reference purpose. Next is color of the design. That can be yellow, yellow pink, white or yellow white. This can be open as many as required by the user. Next is customer. If the given design is exclusive to a customer, then the customer can be specified over here. Then is customer code. If a given design needs to be set as an exclusive for a given customer, then user will need to specify the customer code over here. Next is apply to customer group, yes or no. If mention yes over here, then this design will be set as exclusive for all the customers belonging to the group of the customer code specified in this field. Customer and region. If a given design needs to be set as exclusive for a given customer, then user will need to specify the customer code over here. For example, C001. Next is apply to customer group, yes or no. If mentioned yes in this field, then the design will be set as exclusive for all the customers belonging to the group of customer specified in the customer code field. Or if it is set as no, then it means that exclusivity is being set specifically for that customer only and not for the whole group. If the customer field is filled, this field cannot be left blank. If the customer field, for example over here, is C001 and this field is no, the design will be exclusive only for the customer C001. Whereas if this field is yes, this design will be available to C001 and to all the customers belonging to the regions other than the region to which C00 belongs to. If the customer field is left blank, this field be blank. Next is parts. This is the number of parts making this design. Preferred vendor is mentioned over here if the design is being supplied by the vendor. Then is the production instruction. Specific instructions, if any, that must be followed for the production of this design have to be mentioned over here. It is copied to the order where it can be altered and later will be printed on the bag also. Then is the design date. Design date is the date on which the design is being made. Then design by. Here we mention the designer's name. Then the created date. Created date is the date when the entry for this design was being made. By default, the system gets the current date, which cannot be modified. Next is the wax weight. Is the wax weight of the design. Next is last modified. Here we will mention the reason for modification and the date of modification. Cast piece weight. User should mention the ideal cast weight of the given design over here. User has also the option to set the tolerance chart based on the cast piece weight. Next is total diamond weight. Here the purpose is to check the correctness of the weight details entered in the bill of material tab, because it is most likely that data entry operator may by mistake enter a wrong weight details. In that case, system gives the error message if the total of the diamond breakup does not matches with the total diamond weight mentioned over here. User may also leave this field blank if such check is not required. Next is source sketch or design code. In the case the design details are copied from some other design, then system by automatically gets the design code or the sketch code over here. Next is model weight with runner and the silver model weight. These two fields are never printed on any of the reports. These two data is only for a reference purpose. Next is bill of material. The bill of material. The bill of material tab consists of the details of RM being used for the design. First is gold. For gold, the subcategory will be dash, then the RM code. Over here it is G18 yellow for the given design in which the design is being manufactured first time. Then the required weight of the RM. Then alloy. The alloy code has to be given against the RM line of main metal. If the alloy code is mentioned, it will affect the rate calculation for that RM. Alloy code is not a compulsory field, so can be left blank. Next is main metal yes or no. Sometimes there are two metals, example gold as well as platinum. In this case, the major metal is to be defined as a main metal. In this case, we have defined gold as a main metal. Next is diamond. The shape of the diamond, the required RM quality and the required size, that is sieve size, then the required quantity of this diamond, RM pointer weight, it is a per piece weight of the stone, then the production weight. This is actually derived by multiplying the production quantity to the RM pointer. So here the value is 0.084. User can modify it. Next is the setting code. Setting code is the type of setting used to fix the diamonds in the design. Example, invisible setting, channel setting, prong, pave, etc. Then the wax set quantity and the handset quantity. Waxed quantity is the number of diamond pieces that are waxed in the design. And the handsets are the number of diamond pieces that are handset in the design. It is the total diamond pieces minus the waxed pieces. Here in this example, as we have set waxed quantity as 0, so system automatically gets the handset quantity as 10. Next is the subshape. It is the subshape of the diamond. For example, in case of bucket, it can be categorized as a square shape bucket or a taper bucket shape. In case of diamonds, it will always be set as main metal, no. Labor details. This tab consists of the details of labor being charged for the design to the customer. This is labor main code, that is CFP, casting, finishing, polishing. The examples of labor main code can be rhodium, milgrain, etc. Next is the subtype of the labor main code. This is basically defined based on the charging pattern. For example, CFP charges for ring is different and for bangle is different. So, user can open a two different code as a labor subcode, that is CFP for ring and CFP for bangle. Here we have categorized it into a more depth, that is CFP charges for gold bangle, single tone, easy bangle, and then gold ring, single tone, difficult ring. Same way, gold ring, single tone, easy. Next is QW option. This we decide over here that how the labor has to be charged, either by quantity or the by weight of the piece. Next is quantity. This field is enabled only if the labor is being charged by the quantity. By default, the quantity is 1 over here, which can be changed as per the requirement. Example, if the casting of bracelet is to be charged based on the number of links in it, then the user has to mention the number of links going in a bracelet. Next is analysis. Next tab is the image tab. System ideally shows the two pictures for a given design, that is a line draw sketch and the 3D picture. This is only if picture for the same are stored at the path specified in the system parameter record, that is PCT. In addition to the line draw sketch and the 3D image, user has the option to store another three pictures of the given design. Here, user can store the top view of the design, side view of the design, and a 3D image. Next is the process production category. In the general tab, system has asked for the production category of a design. But it is not necessary that if it is defined ring easy for a given design, then for all the processes like polishing, filing, this design be easy while manufacturing. So system has provided an option where user can define the production category for each process location. For example, for filing, this design can be easy, but the same design for process polishing might be difficult. So, in this case, the workers will get point accordingly based on the complexity of the design in a given process. The copy frame. Instead of re-entering the details, the copy option in the design master help us to copy the details of some other design from the design master or sketch master or part master to the target design. Next is a summary. The summary button at a glance shows the caratage and gross weight of the design. It also summarizes the RM details at one line per RM category and subcategory. The marketing card and job card. This allows the user to save the PDF file for a given design which might be required on the production floor by the production user. Next is the marketing card. Marketing card is also a PDF file which can be stored as a specific path so as the marketing person can refer this PDF file while generating an order for this particular design. Next is the matrix view. Matrix view allows the user to save 9 different images of a given design as per their different views at the different process locations. Here we complete the understanding of Design Master. Next is the Design Sketch Master. The detail stored over here is also similar to the Design Master. Only the purpose differs over here. The purpose of the Sketch Master is to store the details of the design which are in the conceptual stages. That is, physical mold of the same do not exist. The design is only sketched and the feasibility of the same is yet to be checked for the production. Yet, we can generate the quotations for the sketch designs. The point to be noted over here is that design stored in the Sketch Master once approved can be copied in the Design Master as it is and can be edited if required. Next is Design Part Master. A design can be further categorized into various parts and details of each part can be stored in the Part Master. For example, if there are 14 links in a bracelet, out of which 7 are plain and other 7 have a diamond set into it, then we will have to create 2 part master, one of each type. The details asked in the part master is also same as the design master. So, here we complete the understanding of the design master, design sketch master and design part master.